Hi everyone, so today we'll be discussing about chassis. We'll start with the components of chassis, then we'll discuss about different functions of chassis, and finally we'll discuss classifications of chassis. So we'll start with the components of automobile first. So basically, as far as automobile or any vehicle is concerned, we'll be having all these components. So first component is superstructure. So superstructure is nothing but the vehicle body itself. So vehicle body can be called as superstructure. So this is a superstructure. Then the next component is basic structure. We know that the vehicle body is mounted on a chassis frame. So we can draw a simple frame in this way. The frame may be having some longitudinal members like this. Or it may be having some transverse members, or it may have some cross members also. So this is again depends on what type of chassis frame is used. We'll be discussing about different chassis frames in next video. So this is a part of this basic structure. So first part is frame. Then the second part is suspension system. So we have to mount the suspension system. Maybe if you are using the spring type suspension, then we may use the springs here at this point, or sometimes you may use the leaf spring as in case of heavy vehicles. So this depends on type of suspension system. Then axles, we need to attach the axles. Maybe axles are mounted at this point. These are the axle, this is the front axle on which wheels and tires are mounted in this, maybe in this way. And here we'll be having a second axle where these wheels are mounted. If these are the wheels, then those are attached at the end of this axle. Suspension system, axles, wheels, four wheels, front wheels and rear wheels. So this is the second component of an automobile, basic structure. Now the most important component, and which can be called as power unit, is engine of that vehicle. So along with the different layout type, the engine location will vary. We may mount the engine at the front position, maybe in the middle position, or maybe at the rear position. So for example, if I am considering the engine here, it is mounted on the front side. This is power unit, which is nothing but engine itself. This engine is connected to the transmission system. So the next component is transmission system. So this engine is connected to the clutch, then it is connected to the gearbox, then through propeller shaft assembly, it is connected to the differential and final drive. Through differential and final drive and through this axles, the power is given to the rear wheels. So this is the most common type of layout, that the engine is mounted at the front and the drive is given to the rear wheels. So this complete system can be called as transmission system. Means power, when it is transferred for output shaft of the engine to the wheels, the system involved is transmission system. And now the next part is controls. Two more systems are there that we need to club with the automobile vehicle. So first is braking system and then steering system. So we may mount a braking system maybe here at this point. This again attached to the chassis frame, and then braking system. So basically, we may go for mechanical braking system, pneumatic braking system, or hydraulic braking system. So basically, if the disc brakes or drum brakes are utilized, may be mounted here at the vicinity of wheels. So we need to mount these two systems on the chassis frame. And the last component, which is auxiliaries. So auxiliaries, it is a optional component. Means whether to attach MP3 player, whether to attach air conditioning system, it is up to the user's requirement or the customer's requirement. So this is an optional component. Means the complete automobile vehicle is consisting of only two parts. For example, I can say automobile or vehicle is nothing but vehicle body plus chassis. Means how the simply chassis can be defined, a complete vehicle without body can be called as chassis. Means these are the components which comprises chassis, or these are the chassis components. We simply, if you think in practically, then we'll find that the chassis frame is simply called as chassis, but actually chassis consists of number of components: basic structure, power unit, transmission system and controls. Now we'll turn towards different functions of chassis. So the first important function of chassis is to sustain the weight of a vehicle. So to support, chassis supports vehicle weight. As we have discussed, a complete vehicle weight may be body weight, and the components those are mounted on the chassis itself may be suspension system, engine, transmission system. So the chassis has to sustain this complete vehicle weight, so that the chassis has to be designed and manufactured with the particular material. Then it supports passenger weight, as body is mounted on the chassis itself. So the passenger weight need to be taken care by the chassis itself. Then withstand stresses due to road conditions. So this is not the only thing that the body weight has to sustain, but when the vehicle is running on the rough road, then due to this rough road, there are some stresses, those are coming from the road surface, and these stresses will be transferred to the tires first, then the wheels, and then through axles, which will be again transferred to the transmission system, and through transmission system it is transferred to the vehicle body. But the first point of contact is the chassis. So the chassis has to sustain or withstand the stresses due to road conditions. Otherwise, these stresses will be transferred to the body and to the passenger compartment. So the passengers will experience the rough road, but as we know that the suspension system is mounted in between, so the passenger will not be able to experience the rough surface. So likewise, you have to decide the stiffness of the suspension system and materials which is used for manufacturing of this chassis for different components. And then it withstand stresses due to braking and acceleration. We know that when the brake is suddenly applied, what will happen? The vehicle weight will be shifted to the front side, and when the suddenly acceleration will be taken place, when we press, a driver will press suddenly acceleration pedal, then what will happen? The vehicle will lift back, means the vehicle weight will be transferred to the rear side. So obviously these weights to be need to be taken care by the chassis itself. So braking and acceleration. And then the next is, it should provide adequate space for mountings. We have discussed here the body is mounted on the chassis, but for example, if these components, all these components mounted on the chassis, those are extruded, maybe here some components are placed in this position, some components are placed in this position on the chassis, then what will happen? The body space will be reduced. So we have to mount the component in such a way that there will be adequate space for the body or other occupants or mountings. And then it should provide capability to steer the vehicle. This is again important function of this chassis system. We know that the steering system is a part of chassis itself, and it is attached to this axles and frame. So it should be designed in such a way that there will be a proper, with the proper rotation or with the simple rotation also, this complete chassis is capable to move. Means if I wanted to take a left turn, then with simple movements of this steering wheel, the chassis will be capable to turn in this direction, maybe in this direction. So likewise, the steering system will be designed, and it is attached with these other components. So last is, it should provide isolation between road and passengers. Obviously, the chassis is the part which is in between road surface and body. So it provides the isolation. So these are the main functions of chassis, and now we'll move toward different types of chassis. So we'll discuss these classifications of chassis with the help of two important domains. First is engine location, and second is layout. Engine location, where the engine is placed, is again very important. And the first type, according to this engine location, which is conventional type of chassis. So whatever sketch I have drawn here, this represents conventional chassis. In conventional chassis, you'll find that driver's cabin is separated from the engine compartment. Means you will find isolated or separate engine compartment. So engine is placed in this portion. So this is engine. Means engine is placed in front of the driver's cabin, or engine compartment is totally different than driver cabins, and that chassis can be called as conventional chassis. There are some disadvantages as far as this chassis type is concerned. First is visibility. See, driver could not see this portion. So this is called as the blind spots. So this is because of this design. We have extruded this part for the engine compartment, and as a reason, this driver is coming across these blind spots. So this is one disadvantage of conventional type of chassis. And the second is, this space is wasted. Whatever space will be having, which is wasted, means if the engine is mounted here in just below the driver's cabin, then we might have utilized this extra space for carrying goods, or capacity of this truck or heavy vehicle will be improved. So first type is conventional type. Then many advancements are done, many research is carried out on this conventional type, and the second type is developed, which is called as semi-forward chassis. So there were little modifications made as far as semi-forward chassis are concerned. It is designed, and the engine compartment, which was completely separate in case of conventional, which has made a little bit of separate, means this part was reduced when it was developed. Then this part was reduced, and the engine is mounted in this way. Half part of engine is mounted just below the driver's cabin, whereas half part is mounted in the engine compartment. So as a result, what happened? These blind spots has reduced. This is reduced as compared to conventional chassis. And this extra space, which is increased here, and this can be utilized for carrying goods, or the capacity of truck or heavy vehicle will be improved. And then the next type is forward type. But still it is having some disadvantages, and as a result of the third chassis type is developed, which is called as forward chassis or fully forward. Forward type of chassis. Here again, few modifications are made. This part is completely removed. So you'll find the engine, this part is made completely flat from front side, and the engine is mounted just below the driver's cabin. Due to this, this space is further increased, and the capacity of truck is further increased. And here also, now you will find the blind spot is reduced to this part only. So this part is not visible to the drivers. So visibility of drivers is improved, and along with the capacity of truck or capacity of any vehicle is improved. So these are the types according to this engine location where engine is mounted. And now we'll move toward the second domain, which is according to the layout. So according to this layout, basically the chassis is classified in four subtypes. So where the complete engine and a complete transmission system is mounted. So the first type is front engine, rear wheel drive. Front engine, rear wheel drive. This can be called as FE, front engine, RD, rear drive, FERD. Means in this case, engine is mounted at front and the drive is given to the rear wheels. So we can indicate this with the help of a block diagram. Simply, we can draw the diagram in this way. This is chassis frame. So here basically, axles are mounted maybe in this way. Front axle, rear axle. I'm not showing all the components. There might be a different component, different members of chassis frame itself. But I have shown only two components and this axles where the wheels are mounted, maybe in this way. So this can be called as layout of a vehicle or layout of a chassis. So front engine, rear wheel drive. Now you have to mount the front engine maybe here at this position. So engine is mounted at the front side, but the drive is given to the rear wheels. Means maybe we have discussed maybe clutch, gearbox, propeller shaft assembly, the drive is given to the rear wheels. So this can be called as front engine, rear wheel drive. Most of the vehicles nowadays, most of the cars, most of the buses, trucks, you are using this front engine, rear wheel drive. This is because of the optimum balance of the weight. For example, see, if the engine is mounted at the front side, some components are mounted at the front side, so load will be transferred to the front side. However, few components are also mounted on the middle portion on the rear side. And the passenger space is provided at this portion. We know that if this is a body, then if the engine is mounted here, then this is a passenger space. So engine load is acted on this part. However, the passenger load will be transferred in this way. So front side load and middle load will be managed or will be balanced, and this is very important as far as vehicle running on the rough surfaces, climbing the hills, down the hills are concerned. So in all those conditions, as this in this front engine rear wheel drive, weight is balanced perfectly. This having the most important advantages of this drive. And again, second, we know that as this is a front side, the air, as soon as we will propel the vehicle, the air which will come from the front side, which will pass over through this engine, and as a result of it will make use of this natural air for cooling purpose. So if the engine is mounted at the rear side, we know that it is not possible, we should provide a separate cooling system or effective cooling system. So natural, we cannot make the use of natural air to cool the engine. The next advantage of this layout is, as driver cabin is somewhere here, or the driver will be somewhere at this position, then at the time of changing the gear, driver will be able to experience the noise, and that is required in case of proper gear shifting. If the gear is need to be shifted from second to third, then driver need to experience the noise of firing or noise of this complete vehicle, so that the drivers will be able to change the gear smoothly. So these are the advantages as far as front engine rear wheel drive is concerned. And now the second is front engine front wheel drive. Means engine is mounted at the front and drive is given to the front wheel. you can call it as front engine, front drive. So now we'll make or we'll eliminate these components. So in this case, rear wheels are freely rotating and the power is given to only the front wheels. So power will be given to the front wheels, maybe in this way. So front engine, front wheel drive. So one of the most important advantage of this front engine, front wheel drive, it is, this drive is capable of lowering the height, floor height. For example, if this is, these are the wheels and this is a road surface, then we have discussed about this FERD. We'll be having different components. In case of FERD, engine will be mounted here and we'll be having different components which will be mounted in this way. So the floor height will be increased. We need to design a vehicle with more floor height. So with the help of this front engine rear wheel drive, it is not possible to reduce the CG or reduce the floor height. So for stability purpose, we have to design a vehicle which is having a minimum CG center of gravity or minimum floor height, then the stability will be improved or increased. So it is possible with the help of this front engine front wheel drive, because engine is mounted here and all these components are mounted here, so we can reduce the floor height. And all other, we can make use of natural air for cooling purpose, and driver will experience the noise. And obviously, if the engine is mounted on the front side, then the passenger space will be increased, or we can make use of luggage space, passenger space. If the engine is mounted in the middle position, so there will be the compromise in the space for passengers. So for that perspective also, this is the advantage for all these types of drives. Now we'll move towards the third drive, which is rear engine. Engine is placed at the rear side, rear engine, rear wheel drive. Rear engine, rear wheel drive means engine is placed at rear side and the drive is given to the rear. So RERD, rear engine, rear drive. So in this case, we mount engine at rear side and the drive is also given to the rear side, means front wheels are freely rotating. But this type of drive is having number of limitations or disadvantages. The first disadvantage, if the engine is mounted on the rear side, obviously we cannot make use of this natural air for the cooling purpose. We should have a very effective cooling system. Then while shifting the gear, driver will not experience this noise. So there will be a difficulty in shifting the gears to the drivers. Then third, if this engine is mounted on the rear side, then obviously the passenger, if the engine is mounted here, then the passenger will experience the noise, and which is not at all expected. So this noise will be transferred to the engine compartment and the passenger will experience the noise. And the most important disadvantage, while climbing the hills, see, this is a practical case. While climbing the wheels, if the load is, engine is mounted at the rear side, if the vehicle is moving up, engine is mounted at the rear side, the passenger are also maybe here in between. So obviously you may think that the complete weight will be transferred to the rear side, and there might be the case that vehicle will roll over and accident will happen. So in that case, will not get the proper adhesion with the road surface. So, and that is the reason you will not find many of cases of, or many of practical applications of this type of drive, rear engine, rear wheel drive. And wherever this rear engine, rear wheel drive is used, those are manufactured for or running for a very slow speeds, maybe 60, 70, 80 or till 100 km per hour. And then the last type of layout or drive is all wheel drive. All wheel drive, or you can call it as four wheel drive. Four wheel drive. So for example, in gypsies or in few vehicles, फोर व्हील ड्राइव इज एम्प्लॉयड. सो इन केस ऑफ फोर व्हील ड्राइव स्पेशली द इंजिन इज माउंटेड इन द मिडल पोजिशन. वन ट्रांसफर केस इज यूज टू ट्रांसफर दिस मोशन इन दिस वे 90 डिग्रीज. यू विल फाइंड वन ट्रांसफर केस विच इज यूज इन ऑर्डर टू ट्रांसफर दिस मोशन टू दिस शाफ्ट एंड देन यू विल फाइंड दिस शाफ्ट आर अटैच टू द एक्सल्स. मे बी डिफरेंशियल्स इज यूज एंड हाफ शाफ्ट आर यूज एंड दिस इंजिन मूवमेंट इज ट्रांसफर टू दिस. सो एज वेन इंजिन विल रन डेफिनेटली दिस शाफ्ट विल रोटेट एंड दिस शाफ्ट विल ट्रांसफर द मोशन टू द रियर व्हील्स एंड फ्रंट व्हील्स. मीन्स ऑल द व्हील्स आर पावर्ड व्हील्स. सो इन केस ऑफ बेसिकली इफ फोर व्हील ड्राइव इज यूज एंड इफ द व्हीकल इज गोइंग थ्रू द मडी सर्फेस देन ऑब्वियसली इन दैट सर्फेस ऑल्सो द व्हीकल विल प्रोपेल. बट इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस थ्री टाइप्स फ्रंट इंजिन और FERD, FEFD एंड RERD. सो वी मे नीड अ सेकेंडरी व्हीकल इन ऑर्डर टू गेट आउट ऑफ द फर्स्ट व्हीकल इफ गोइंग थ्रू द मडी सर्फेस. बट ऑब्वियसली द कॉस्ट ऑफ फोर व्हील ड्राइव विल इंक्रीज. सो यूल गेट प्रॉपर adhesion, प्रॉपर ट्रैक्शन एंड दिस फोर व्हील ड्राइव व्हीकल्स इज डिजाइन टू गो थ्रू द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सर्फेसेस. नाउ विल डिस्कस सम प्रैक्टिकल इमेजेस ऑफ चासिस. दोज आर नाउ वर्ड इज यूज इन द ऑटोमोटिव इंडस्ट्री. हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज अ चासिस ऑफ एक्चुअल व्हीकल वेर यूल फाइंड सम लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल मेंबर्स. दिस आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ चासिस फ्रेम. मे बी टू इन नंबर्स ऑन द रियर साइड ऑल्सो यूल फाइंड दिस लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल मेंबर्स एंड यूल फाइंड नंबर ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स एंड क्रॉस मेंबर्स. देन दिस इज बेसिकली फ्रंट इंजिन रियर व्हील ड्राइव टाइप चासिस. मीन्स द इंजिन इज माउंटेड एट द फ्रंट साइड वेर एज द ड्राइव इज गिवन. सो यू विल फाइंड हियर समवेयर यू विल फाइंड क्लच. हियर यू विल फाइंड दिस गियर बॉक्स एंड देन यू विल फाइंड दिस इज अ प्रोपेलर शाफ्ट विच इज कनेक्टेड टू दिस डिफरेंशियल एंड थ्रू द डिफरेंशियल दिस इज कनेक्टेड टू दिस हाफ शाफ्ट और लाइव शाफ्ट and to the wheels. So accordingly the power is transferred. So this is the complete chassis where all the systems we have discussed about different components of chassis. Chassis frame is there, all the components are mounted, steering system is there, you will find the suspension system is there. So all the systems are also mounted, braking system is there. So this is a complete form of chassis. So we have discussed this, just go through it. See, in this way basically engine compartment is separated from the driver's cabin or driver's compartment and the vehicle will look like this representation. So this is the actual sketch where the engine is mounted. Here this is a driver cabins. Then this is a semi forward type chassis. Half part of engine is forwarded just below the driver's cabin and half is in front of driver's cabin. So this space is, this blind spot is reduced. And then full forward or fully forward chassis, you will observe here no part is extruded in front and obviously the blind spot is reduced and will be having some extra space for carrying goods. So these types of vehicles you might have seen, those are there on the road or in practice they have different practical applications. And then we have discussed with the help of this type of block diagram, simple block diagram, you will be able to explain different types of layouts. As you can see here, the engine, in this way engine is mounted, clutch, gearbox, then different universal joints, maybe slip joints are there. This is a propeller shaft and this is the differential. So this is front engine, front wheel drive. If it is a rear engine, rear wheel drive, you have to shift that this assembly to the rear side and there will be no any components in between. If it is a all wheel drive, the engine is mounted here, transfer case is used and the drive is transferred to all wheel. So all wheels will be powered. So in this way you will be able to explain this all the types of drives or chassis classification based on layout. Now just go through one short video clip so that you will have better understanding about how the chassis is built in a company.